this is my tradition whenever I teach calculus 1. My very last lecture example is always on how to find the volume of a donut, aka a torus. And I also buy my students Krispy Kreme donuts just in case if they never had that before. So you can imagine we'll all be eating donuts and do calculus. Sounds a lot of fun, right? Yes, but after an hour, we all get sugar crash. But anyway, today I will show you guys 3 ways on how to find the volume of a donut. But to make this more interesting, of course we'll find the volume of an actual Krispy Kreme donut. So have a look right here. So before we start, I know the summer has just started, so I think it's really important for you to make a good plan in order to make your summer productive. Therefore, I would like to thank our sponsor today, Polygence, because they can help you achieve more in the summer. Polygence is a research academy dedicated to help middle school and also high school students looking for one-on-one mentorship from top universities such as Harvard, MIT, Stanford, and more. Once you get paired up with a mentor, then you can decide on a research project to work on. So here we have Anna, a high school sophomore who is currently working on 3 math research projects. Because only a small percentage of young adults have the intention to manage their savings, with the intention of economic and finance, Anna came to Polygence looking for a more personal learning experience. Feel free to pause the video and read the abstracts of her projects. Not only this research opportunity can help you when you apply to college or grad school, but also it will give you a deeper understanding of the topic, which is the most important thing. If you would like to sign up for Polygence today, then use my link in the description so that you can get $250 off of your Polygence program. Get paired up with an expert mentor in your industry of choice to make your passion project a reality. Firstly, this is how you can draw a donut. No, not done yet. I know this looks like a potato, but if you do this and that, hopefully it looks more like a donut now. And then we can see that the cross section here is a circle. And the idea is that we have to take the circle and rotate about the y-axis. This is how we can generate a donut, aka a torus. All right, and then we see that the measurement from here to here is about 3 centimeters. And then from here to here, it's about 9.5 centimeters. All right, so now let's go ahead and put this down onto the x and y plane so that we can use an equation later. So we have a circle here first, and then rotate this about the y-axis. So I will just put down like a mirror image here, and then I'll just connect them like this, like that. So this is how the donut looks like from the side. All right, and now let's put down some numbers on the x-axis. We see that from here to here is 9.5, cut into half. That means from here to here, it will be 4.75. And then from here to here is 3, so that means we subtract 3, this right here will be 1.75, and the radius is 1.5, so just add 1.5, we get 3.25. So now, we need an equation of this blue circle. It's not bad, because we can just use the standard form. Here's the center, 3.25, 0, so we have x minus 3.25, and then we have to square that, and we add it with y squared, and that's equal to the radius, which is 1.5 squared. Good. Okay, so how exactly do we get the volume of a donut like this? And this is called the solid of revolution. The first method is we can use the so-called washer method. It's pretty much the disk method for the outer piece minus the disk method for the inner piece. So I'm going to give you guys 2 pictures, right? So the first picture, it will look like this. We need to know the equation on the side, right here, the outer piece, so that when we do the rotation, we can get the outer piece like so. So this will be the whole thing, yeah? But we do have a hole in the middle because it's a donut, so we will have to subtract. So here is the subtraction, subtract the volume of the inner piece. So the inner piece will be this part, right? This part, technically it should be right here. So I will take this and then mirror image that, and then that's like the hole in the middle. So that's the idea. And of course, all this part right here, they are meant to be perfect circles. So now, this part is the x equation from here, but that's the positive version, you'll see. Let's go ahead and just solve x from here. And we will end up with two equations, because when we take the square root, we have to do the plus or minus. Firstly, let's put this to the left, so we will have 1.5 squared and then minus y squared, and then of course we have to take the square root now. So we take the square root, and then don't forget that we have that plus or minus, and then move this number to the right hand side, so 3.25 here. So we do have two equations. This one is the one with the positive, so I will write down. And this one is the one with minus. So let's take a look right here first. We are using the disk method for this, and to do so, the volume of a disk, again, it's just like a very thin cylinder. We need to know the radius from here to here, and that's exactly the horizontal distance, namely just x. And then the vertical distance is the height or the thickness. And because this is just a small change in terms of y, so that will be the y. And for a disk, I will just put this down right here for you guys. A volume of a disk, or a very thin cylinder, it's equal to pi times the radius squared times the thickness or the height. So that's pretty much the idea. So for this one, we are going to get pi times the r, which is x, which is just this part. And we have to use this right here, because later on we'll be in the y world. We have the y for the thickness. So I'm just going to write down. This is the radius. We will have to square that, and then we multiply by the thickness, which is dy. But this right here is just the volume of the red disk. We want the whole thing. Therefore, we will have to integrate this. And because we are in the y world, we have to pay attention to the y values, the starting and then the end. Well, let's look back to here again. The radius of the blue circle is 1.5. And then if you look down here, the lowest y value is negative 1.5. And this part is just so that I can make the picture look as 3D. So you look at this very button, it's negative 1.5. And then this right here to the circle is 1.5. So we will just have to integrate this from negative 1.5 to positive 1.5. This right here is the volume of the outer piece, assuming that you do not have like an actual donut with a hole. You have like a Boston cream, that kind of thing. All right, but we do have the center that's missing, so we will have to subtract this. So minus, pretty much the same thing. Integral, and then we have pretty much the same thing, but just this right here, change that to a minus. So this right here will be the setup to get the volume of the donut. And usually for this kind of questions, I would just focus on the setup, because usually a lot of students will mess on the setup. If you want the students to also do the integrals by hand, it doesn't make sense anymore, because if the setup was wrong, right? So once we set this up, let's just use the graphing calculator. And if you work that out, you will get approximately 144.343 centimeters cubed. So that's how big a Krispy Kreme donut is. I don't know if I did this right or wrong, because usually this is pretty hard, right? So let's go ahead and try to use the shell method. So for the shell method, the idea is the following. We are going to make a vertical cut right here, and then we are going to wrap it around about the y-axis. So we are going to get this right here as well. And each wrap has a volume. It's like a really thin paper, that kind of thing. And the idea here is that we will have to know the volume of that thin paper, because we see that it goes around like so. So we will need to know from here to here. And that's, again, the radius. So I'll just put down x for now, because the radius is horizontal, so that's why it's x. But the idea is that it's 2 pi times the radius. That's going to give you the whole width of the paper. And then we will also have to multiply by the height, right? So multiply by the height of the paper, because it's going to be like a rectangle. But this is just the area of a paper, rectangular paper, we also need to multiply by the thickness so that we can get the volume. So last thing that we do is multiply by thickness. So this is the volume of each shell, which is again the volume of each like a vertical sheet of rectangular paper. All right, so now as we can see, the R is the X, that's good. What's the height though? Well, the height from here to here is the vertical distance, which is Y, and then from here to here, guess what? It's technically negative Y because it's on the bottom, but we're talking about volume, so we just treat it as positive as well. So the whole thing is 2Y, all right? And what's the thickness though? Well, look at how we draw it right here. This time, unlike earlier, the change is in terms of X. So this little thing right here is dx. So this is the advantage of using the shell method over the disk method or slash the washer method earlier. We don't have to do any subtraction. But anyway, let's see this right here. Again, we are in the X world, okay? And then let's just continue. We have the 2 pi, that's good. And then the R is just X. And X is allowed in the X world, so that's perfect. I'm just gonna put down X. However, Y, it's not allowed in the X world. So from here, we will have to solve for Y. So let's go ahead and do that. Put this to the other side and then just take the square root. We see that Y is going to be plus or minus square root of 1.5 square minus parentheses X minus 3.25 square, like that. But again, in our case here, the H is technically 2Y. So we are just going to multiply this by 2 and then the Y is just that. So this is going to give us the volume of each shell. And then we just have to integrate this. And now we have to worry about because we are in the X world. So look at the X value. It starts at 1.75 up to 4.75. So this right here will be the setup for using the shell method. And again, we'll just focus on the setup, right? So once we have this set up, let's just go ahead and use a calculator to solve it. We get about the same answer. 144.343 centimeter cube. Of course, we did it right earlier as well. So that is what we have. Now, I want to show you guys the best way to find the volume of a donut. This right here is called the Pappus Theorem. And I'm going to do a proof for you guys later on. This is what it says. Volume is equal to area times distance. Too simple, but I'm going to explain the distance in a little bit. Let me give you guys intuition first. Well, how do we find the volume of a cylinder? The volume of the cylinder is pi r squared times h, isn't it? What's pi r squared? Well, the cross section here is a circle. This is just pi r squared. Good. And then, why do we multiply by h? The h is the height. But you can see that it's just pretty much the area here multiplied by the distance that you have to go all the way from bottom to the top, isn't it? Yes, so that's the idea. And technically, for the d right here, we had to talk about the so-called centroid. But since we are talking about circles, the centroid is just literally right in the middle. That's all. So I will tell you the distance here is technically the distance traveled from the centroid. So now let me draw a donut for you guys again, like so. Well, we have our cross section, which is just a circle, and the area for that is just pi r squared. Good. Now, what's the distance that it traveled? It will be like this, right? Like this, like this way, like this way. Yeah, so it's also going to be traveling a circular distance. So it's going to travel like this right here. And again, we have to measure it from the center, aka the centroid. So what's this distance in blue though? Well, that will be using this center right here as the center. And then you have to look at the radius here because this is the circumference for that blue region, right? For the blue circular pathway. I'm going to call this capital R. And then the distance that we need here, it will just be 2 pi r for the circumference. So ladies and gentlemen, thanks to Pappus Theorem, the volume of a donut, or torus, this is just equal to pi r squared. Let me just put this down right here. And then we multiply by 2 pi capital R. Of course, we can simplify this a little bit. This is just 2, and then we have pi squared, and then R squared, and then capital R. This is the volume of a donut. So now, let's look back here. Okay, what's the radius of the blue circle? Well, from here to here is just 1.5. So ladies and gentlemen, volume is going to be equal to, let me just put this down, pi times 1.5 squared, all right? Now, here's the harder part. What will be the capital R? Again, we use this as a center, and then we will just have to make sure that it travels like so. And then that's the distance, right? The radius for that. Okay, so what's the distance from here to here? Remember the picture that we did earlier? 4.75 minus 1.5, 3.25. This right here is 3.25. So anyway, we just have to multiply by 2 pi times 3.25. Yes, we will get approximately 144.343 centimeters cubed. This is definitely the best way to find the volume of this donut. What do you guys think? Which method did you like the most? And let me also know that how you did in your Calc 1 class. This is the summertime now, so hopefully everybody will have a good summer. And if you want to make your summer productive, go ahead and check out Polygence.